Here we go. The wind is coming.
Waiting.
Hallelujah. God is moving. Yes, hallelujah. Some people were dancing. Hallelujah. You had the space down there. And all the other, you were stuck in your chair. But you see, maybe when you come home and you put on some music, you can start to move and praise God. I don't know if you have done that. What are you talking about? Now, I don't do that. Well, I would like to tell you that what the people of God need is freedom. We need freedom. Hallelujah. We have been tied up and so tired and so afraid of letting the Holy Spirit just flow and just rejoice in God. Hallelujah. But I would like to tell you that I know how it is to be in that situation when you don't know exactly what's going on. What shall I do? It feels so sad. It feels so hard. And some years ago, I was sitting in our living room, and I just felt God was ministering to me and how He really wanted to help me to come out more and more into the freedom that God has for me. You know, we can listen to what people say and many, many different things, circumstances that hold us back. But God is calling us into a new freedom. And in Psalm 137, we can read about when the people of Judah were captured in Babylon. And they said, well, sing us the songs. And they said, how shall we sing? We cannot sing. And they hang up their lyres, yeah, in the trees. And they were so sad. Some of you here today are in that situation. Maybe it looks nice on the outside, but inside you are crying. But God is calling you to come out into His freedom. And I was sitting there in my living room, and a text, lyrics came to me, and also the melody. And I didn't know how to express everything in this. So I tried to get some help from my dear friend Toby to arrange it. And suddenly I just felt, well, here it is. The text, the music is together. And just join me in this song. You don't have to sing. I think you cannot pick up the song, but just follow me through the different sentences.
Rivers of Babylon, there was a town of wept when we remembered Zion. There we hung up our lyres on the poplar trees, for our captors there asked us for songs and our tormentors for rejoicing. Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How can we sing the Lord's song on foreign soil?
fear of man and fear of failure. Quench the light that lies within. Something has happened, it's hard to see. All is paralyzed, closed and get it still. If I do not remember you, Jerusalem. So come and dance now. Yes, come and dance and feel the freedom in the air. Oh. your life. Oh, hallelujah. God will reveal himself for you in his word. Maybe this is a different service you are coming to. But we are serving the same God, aren't we? Hallelujah! God is so good, so wonderful. And you see, even since when I was a little child, I think I was maybe around 4 years old, I was sitting in the kitchen playing with something in one of the drawers, yeah. And suddenly it just came to me. When I grow up, I will sing. I just knew it. And that was something that came to me so strong as a child. Could never leave me. When I was a teenager, I was crying out to God, God, what shall I do? Where is my path in life? And I was studying and went to schools and all that, and I joined youth choirs and I was leading youth choirs and I was involved in many, many different things, and still had this feeling. And then I went to a Bible school, and after some years I became the music director, and we also had a music school there. But actually I'm not educated in music at all. It just happened. Sometimes the anointing over our life just make a way. Yeah? But then I got my third child, and after that our fourth child. So I realized my family needs me at home. So then I felt how the life really changed. But in one way I was satisfied because it was right for that season. But on the other hand, I knew I have something inside of me that need to come out. And then we moved with our whole family to Israel. Our children went to Israeli schools, learned Hebrew and all that. And it was a really heavy thing to take care of the whole family with all those different things and not know the language, and everything was new. And I didn't know the holidays. You know, they have a lot of holidays in Israel, especially in September, October, November. You never know what will happen. And we went to school and the school was closed. Okay, there is no school today. What kind of holiday is it now? So we tried to figure out a lot of things. We were so confused. So we were living that kind of life for some years. And then we came back to Sweden and I started to work with what I'm educated to, with my professional work, and that is a teacher. I'm a teacher, high school teacher in mathematics and chemistry. So I had to dig into all those things again. And you see, when I was a teacher in the Bible school about praise and worship 10 years earlier or something, I told the students, as far east is from west, that's how far it is for me to go back. Let me see, I need to change. Now it's easier to hear. That's so far for me to go back to work as a teacher. And here I am, working now as a teacher. Can it be God? Yes, I was happy. I was so satisfied to see a new season in life. But all the time I had this going on inside of me, where is the music, the song? So, one day, 8 years ago, my dear friend Toby came back to Sweden with his family. He had lived there in the States for some years as a music minister. And actually, I have known him longer than I have known my husband. He and some other guys played for me when we were young. And he met my husband and said to him, "Tell Eleonora that she is not done singing." And Kurt came home and told me. And I just felt the Holy Spirit just hit me. And I knew I'm stepping into a new season in life. But it didn't happen overnight. When you don't know what to do, what shall you do then? You need to start to pray. So I gathered some of my friends who were involved in music, but they didn't have it so much working in their lives at that moment. But we started to come together and pray. And I just saw how God started to open up doors step by step. And new songs began to come to me. And the first song that came to me is called Changes. I saw something that started in my life. And in Isaiah, yeah, 43:19, it says, "See, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. do you not perceive it? I'm making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. And if you can take that challenge, are you ready to be changed in your life? Are you ready to take the word of God into your life? What are the things your heart can see? What are the things you're dreaming of? Can dreams become reality and happen in your life? Well, that's the question. And about your comfort zone, your struggle with complacency, old habits, all those things, the word of God is calling you. No time to play more games. And it's a happy song because it's wonderful to walk with God. But the lyrics are challenging you today. What are the things your heart can see? What are the things you're dreaming of? Can dreams become reality and happen in your life? Adjustments of a heart delight take away your adieu things. When he speaks his words to you, listen and obey. He will lead you on as you listen to his voice. Yes, your heart is crying out. Oh, he will lead you on. Now walk boldly in his grace. Yes, your longing to be changed. Change that sometimes holds you back. Your struggle with the complacency. Old habits steal your breath. You'll never win without a fight. Make up your mind forever now. The word of God is calling you. No time to play more games. He will lead. Your heart is crying out. Oh, he will lead you on. Now walk boldly in his grace, and your longing to be on your lack of goals, a change that sometimes holds you back. You struggle with complacency, old habits steal your breath. Yeah, you never win without a fight. Make up your mind forever now. The word of God is calling you. No time, no time to play more games. Lead you on. still longing.
He will lead you on as you listen to his voice.
For your heart keeps crying out.
He will lead you on. Now walk boldly in his grace.
For your longing to be changed.
Ooh, 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 ooh. Hum, ba-da, ba-da, hum. Ooh, da, ba-da, ba, ba-da.
I'm doing something new. Do you see what's going on? It brings up with new life and the strength to carry on. Away in the wilderness, away in the wasteland, it springs up, something new. Oh. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Is it okay to sing one more song at the end? I would like to sing one more song that is called I Need to Be Hungry. I need to be hungry. This song came to me at a hotel room somewhere in the world. Well, you see, we can hear about different things happening. Wow, something is going on here, something is going on there. Great meetings, great preachers. And we want to go there, and that's okay. But if we are not hungry for God, it doesn't matter where you go. You just go and check, oh, this was nice. Well, a lot of people there, okay. And then you just continue your ordinary life, on and on. Nothing special happens. And you wonder, what do they feel? I don't understand. And maybe you are a little bit confused. But what it's all about is that we need to have that hunger after God. God, if I don't have you, my life is not worth anything at all. Do you understand? We are chasing so lot of things on this earth. Beautiful things, cars and apartments and clothes and all those things. And so stupid, we think that those things can satisfy us. Maybe for a moment, but it doesn't help you for the future. And now I would like to sing this song. And you sit here and you pray. You pray. And you just stir up that hunger for God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.